Hey everyone, I have something to say to DC and Warner Brothers and Fox and Sony. Hey, look what happens when you don't fuck with people and let them make the movie they want.
I am Jack's complete lack of surprise.
Welcome to the Pop Culture Cult. I'm Sean.
I'm Janice.
And we are back. We have been gone for the last...
I just walked in to find you with a sad look upon your face.
Here we go. We've been singing for like 2 weeks. So we've been gone for 2 weeks. 2 weeks ago, we were at, we're part of a medieval reenactment group, and we had the biggest event here locally. We had 3,300 people at the event. We were there for 11 days. This one over here ran it.
With lots of help.
And so we were out camping for a week. And then the week after, we got back on Monday, and Tuesday we did a lot of this.
Yes.
And we watched a lot of Doctor Who, and so, you know, we didn't feel up to it. I did the unboxing for the Nerd Block this month. You'll also notice that our spirit animal, John Borman, has decided to show the world that he's not straight.
In case you didn't know,
he is our spirit animal, but you know, that's okay. We love him anyways.
It makes the frame look crooked.
It totally looks. Maybe if we straighten the frame, maybe he'll look. I won't want to mess with it because it's all gonna fall and stuff. But we'll fix it. This is what happens when you do last minute costume changes. We've got to get into some stuff that happened. Most recently, we won't worry about the stuff that happened weeks ago. There's actually a real director for Batman, and Ben Affleck is actually going to stay for now, but that's weeks old now. So we're going to get to the up-to-date stuff. We're going to start off talking about our review of Logan. Now, I want to point out that we are not going to try to spoil stuff, but we might get in
accidentally.
Well, okay. I was just saying enthusiastic.
Oh, okay.
And then maybe accidentally say something. So, spoilers.
We will try not to spoil it.
I'm just going to shadow your face, apparently, with the sign. So, Logan review. Okay, that was awesome. That's the way you do it. Back to what I said. Hey, Warner Brothers DC, let the filmmakers make their film.
It's shocking. I know.
Wait. If I don't have to put all my fingers in the pie, Cthulhu, or whatever the fuck you say his name.
Cthulhu,
that's it. I always put an extra in there. Cthulhu, stop putting your fingers in all the goddamn pies. James Mangold, who wrote it and directed it, did an amazing job with the movie. If that is truly the last we see as Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, that's the way to go out. Makes up for all... everything we've been looking for. What did you think, without trying to spoil it too much?
I thought it was awesome. I think we might have to see it again.
Yeah.
We went with friends. We have our typical debriefing after the movie. And there was a lot of... Well, that was a heartwarming, uplifting movie. Tongue-in-cheek.
Still a better love story than Twilight. That was one of the comments.
Yeah. It's good. It's sad. If you leave the theater without a couple tears, then
yeah.
you have no heart.
You have no heart. You have no emotional connection to these characters at all.
Right. But as people said, and we even said it that night over dinner... It's not a movie that you have to have seen.
Yes.
Any of the other X-Men or yes. Wolverine movies
absolutely.
To get.
Absolutely. It is standalone is not quite the right term, but it stands alone from the X-Men universe.
Yeah, you could know nothing about anybody in the movie
nothing.
And still care about what happens.
It's a full-on drama with characters with superpowers. It's not really a comic book movie, and proving that you can do good stories based off of comic books and their characters, and telling the story. I mean, go read all the frickin' stuff that Stan Lee's ever talked about with everything that's happened with Captain America and Spider-Man and everything, and how they directly took stuff that was going on in the culture at the time and put it within the comics, the comics, and just, you know, Captain America standing on top of the World Trade Center rubble, helping save people in one of the comics. I mean, there's good stories in there, and this is just a great example of that. Rated R. It was rated R right off the bat. The first word that Logan says is fuck. And the opening scene is awesome. It's the movie itself is a road trip western. I kind of thought about that later on. It's definitely a road trip movie.
Well, a lot of westerns are road trips.
Yes.
Just in wagons.
In wagons, on horseback or whatever. It's definitely a western. They definitely make a reference to it being a western within the movie. And so it's definitely, it's really, really, really well done. And we were talking about it last night. We're trying to think of movies that have already come out this year. It's March 6th. And so we're like, I'll say it. March 6th, Logan will be in the running for an Oscar nomination.
Well,
Best Picture.
Yeah, okay, as Best Picture. Because, I mean, it probably should anyway, because a lot of the comic book movies for design or costume or makeup whatever, but for the actual, I mean, Hugh Jackman should get
nominated. Hugh Jackman was nominated. Amazing in it.
I thought...
Probably his best performance that we've seen.
I thought Patrick Stewart was amazing. Yeah. I mean, I believed he had Alzheimer's.
Yeah.
I believed him.
Yeah.
And the little girl was amazing.
The little girl
too.
Is awesome. It's not okay. This is kind of a spoiler, so I'll kind of do this kind of spoiler. She doesn't talk for half of it, and so, but she's really, really, really cool. And the stuff they do, how they explain a lot of stuff, makes a lot of sense. And it's set in the future, the typical Sony X-Men universe. The timeline has no. Like, there's no continuity through any of these movies. This is set in the future. There's kind of references to stuff that happened in the past, but not... It's its own movie. It's its own... It exists by itself.
And there's references to things that have happened in the past that we don't know about.
Yeah. And they don't explain it. Which
so...
I think is kind of cool. Because that's not really what the movie is about.
I know, but why put it in there? Yeah. Are they going to do it like... I don't know.
Should be interesting. But it was... it made $85 million on opening weekend. They were hoping for the mid-50s. and so $85 million. And there's a lot of word of mouth going around how good it was. We'll see how well it does. Because Friday is Kong Skull Island. So we'll see what the drop-off is like.
Yeah. Yeah.
We might have to do sushi and giant monkeys.
Okay.
Somebody's birthday is coming up, so we have a discount at sushi. So.
I like sushi.
Yeah, I like sushi. And sake. One of the things that happened before Logan, the movie happened... It wasn't a trailer. It was a short.
It was brought in weird because you thought it was the beginning of the movie, all of a sudden it wasn't.
And so they did this. They did this Deadpool short. It's like 3.5 minutes long. We had watched it on the internet on Saturday, and then saw it in the theater. And there's two different versions of it. The internet version is different than the movie version. But it's just a straight out Deadpool promotion for it to come, and there's 8 million freaking Easter eggs. I've watched it 5 times, pausing it every couple of seconds to try to look at the stuff in the background. The big thing for me was the Firefly posters.
Yeah.
And not Serenity posters. There's a difference.
No.
The Firefly posters. And they talked about it today on Collider. Was this mean that Nathan Fillion's going to be Cable? And that we're going to... And one of the other... One of the girls on there said, well, what about Moriana, whatever, Inara from Firefly, who's in Deadpool. Maybe it's kind of a wink and nod to her. Hello!
Oh, no.
Oh, wait, no, I don't understand. So that one's pretty... that's just as super Firefly fans that we are... my hat, where's my hat? My hat's over there. I have a Jane hat, it's over there. I have a Christmas ornament, it's on the fan up there. I won't move the computer so you can see it. As super Firefly fans that we are, it's always awesome when there's references in pop culture to a show that lasted 10 episodes.
Screw you, Fox.
You go home. So the premise is there's a guy getting beat up in the alley, and Wade sees it, and so he goes into a phone booth to change. The Superman music goes off, and there's this giant wrestling match in this phone booth as Wade tries to get it changed.
There's some gratuitous Ryan Reynolds butt.
But yeah, if I had awesome. An ass like that, I'd be flinging it all over the place too. On the phone booth, though, it says Nathan Summers is coming, and Nathan Summers is Cable's real name. And Nathan was Scott Summers' son, right? So it makes sense of what's going on. We'll get into the whole who's going to play Cable here in a second. There's some like a bunch of different graffiti things. One says Ray, spelled with an E, like Ray from Star Wars. I don't know what that means, but it's kind of obvious. It's this huge piece behind the phone booth. There's somebody's getting text while we're getting to a show. Professionalism around here sucks. There's a trash can that says Alley Cats on it. Deadpool comes out of the phone booth, and Stan Lee stand there and says, "Nice suit." And Deadpool, "Zip it, Stan Lee." And it's actually Stan Lee standing there. There's just there's tons and tons and tons and tons of Easter eggs. Some people said maybe not the best placement in front of Logan, but
there was a bunch of Logan posters stuff in there,
right?
And he loves Hugh Jackman.
Yeah.
And if you watch the internet one, so the movie trailer one didn't have it, but the internet one does, where he goes on. I mean, he talks about Hugh Jackman for a minute because he says, "What kind of suit would he change into?
Jeans
and a tank top,
right?"
And but he goes on the internet one for like 30 seconds he's talking with an Australian accent and he's and his infatuation with Hugh Jackman and it totally makes sense to me.
I thought it was funny, the funny before the serious some people had a problem with. I think outside the Firefly thing was the scrolling credit of the man in the boat fishing thing. It's like it goes, it's like this big old long thing and it goes and that's it, and you have to go by and freeze frame it and read all of it. It makes no sense. I don't know, we'll have to go back and reread it. It's a lot of fun, go watch it. It's all over the internet and it's on our page, Pop Culture Cult on Facebook. Alright, so I was talking about Cable. So there's been 1,001 rumors about who's going to play Cable since they announced in the post credit scene the Ferris Bueller Day Off Deadpool mashup and the post credit scene they're gonna have Cable. It makes sense. And so there's been a ton of rumors all over the place of who it was gonna be. I've heard Russell Crowe, Michael Shannon has been, there was a picture floating around of Hugh Jackman, Ryan Reynolds, and Pierce Brosnan sitting together at Sony Picture Studios.
So Michael Shannon said he quit Hollywood.
Well,
after...
I heard that he wanted to do it, but it was a scheduling conflict.
Oh, because
so
after whatever the last thing was that came out, it was just recently.
Yeah,
and he said I quit Hollywood. I was like,
all right. Kevin Nash has been rumored. I think Kevin Nash would be really cool, but I know Cable's supposed to be this big older guy. I think Kevin Nash is probably too big. Although Ryan Reynolds is a tall guy. He's like 6'3", 6'4". So I think he could, it would make sense.
Stick him on a box. It's fine.
Yeah. The one I think it should be is Stephen Lang. Stephen Lang is the bad guy from Avatar.
Right.
And he's in Don't Speak as the blind guy. I think it should be him. He's like 64. He's J.K. Simmons ripped. He looks the part.
He looks like Cable.
He looks like Cable. It's awesome. But the big one that's come out recently that kind of sounds like the leading candidate is David Harper. And everybody goes, David Harper? Who's David Harper? David Harper is Chief Harper in Stranger Things. So the chief who starts realizing that if he beats people up, he can get his shit, he can get shit figured out in Stranger Things, is like kind of in talks, or is the biggest rumor going around right now.
I think he might have to buff up a little bit.
Well, there's a picture floating around of artwork of him as Cable, and that's him as Cable.
Okay.
I don't know how I feel about it. Well, I'll share the picture later, but I don't know how I feel about it.
I know that that's him, but okay.
That's what they're talking about. So,
He needs to buff up. That's a drawing. You can draw anybody. That's true. He needs to. He's kind of got the dad punch going.
Well, he's supposed to be a aging small town America cop in Stranger Things,
right?
But one of the things that I've read about. Having David Harper as the guy is Cable is the secondary character in the movie, and so you want somebody who's not gonna overshadow Ryan Reynolds.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
So that kind of takes out Pierce Bronson. Pierce Bronson would probably work, but Russell Crowe. I mean, Russell Crowe looks the part, but he's too big of a name. Yeah. I think he'd be too big. But just kind of some interesting talks of what's going on. And if any, Millie Bobby Brown is going to be in the new Godzilla. So anytime the kids are in, and the kid who plays Lucas, if he doesn't do a Michael Jackson biopic, I don't know what's wrong. I don't know what's wrong. Now we're going to talk about something that's going to make me really, really mad. There's discussion of a reboot of Tron. Okay. The original Tron, when it came out, was, I'll say, groundbreaking?
Yes. Oh, it absolutely was.
And kind of changed how everything was. A bazillion games came out, all in the arcades. I played the crap out of it. It was awesome.
I think it was the first time that movies were tied to video games.
Yeah. And it was just an awesome movie. And then a few years ago, they brought Jeff Bridges back. And they digitally did his face so he could play a younger version of himself and an older version of himself in Tron Legacy. I love Tron Legacy. I think it's amazing. We went and saw it in 3D on IMAX, and we're like, oh, it's a really cool, stunning, but I don't know if the story holds up. We went home and watched it on DVD. It holds up. The story is really, really well. It made $400 million. The budget was just under $200 million. Okay, so you double your money. You would think Disney's like, hey, we've got this franchise. We're going to do this thing. We're going to go along with it. Let's make the third one. The third one was in pre-production. They had a script, and they said, never mind, we'll do Pitch Perfect 2. And so I learned that they were expecting Tron Legacy to make over $700 million worldwide. And so because it didn't triple or quadruple their money, they decided not to make it. So now they're talking about redoing it. They're talking about rebooting the whole franchise with a brand new story, and they want to have Jared Leto play a character called, I have it in here somewhere, Eris. A-R-E-S. So Eris? Yeah. I like Jared Leto. I think Jared Leto in the Tron universe would be amazing. Just continue the story that you have. The script is already there. Tron Ascension was going to be the name of the movie, and it was how everybody on the grid was trying to get out, and half the movie was going to be on the grid, and half the movie was going to be in real life. And explain.
I don't know. Somebody from DC went to Disney.
Yeah, apparently. I don't understand. There's no rhyme or reason for it. I just don't get it. You have a great concept sitting there. Just let it go. It just continue on with the franchise. You could now you have everything set up from Tron Legacy. It's not going to be $200 million to set up to do. Half of that, I'm sure half of that was the freaking technology that they had to make.
Well, yeah, I mean the digital recreation or whatever of Jeff Bridges' face was pretty groundbreaking.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they perfected it and used it in Rogue One.
Rogue One, yeah.
So, you know, that's done. I don't know.
I don't get it. I don't get
why
it.
Why are we rewriting a story? I mean, obviously, even a reboot, there's a new character, so it's not. You're not just retelling the same original story and then legacy.
Yeah.
You're
restarting the whole thing.
I don't understand.
Although Disney 9 times out of 10 knows what they're doing. This might be their one flub.
Maybe.
Maybe
somebody over there just hates Tron.
Which is stupid because they completely own all the rights. They don't share it with anybody.
I know, but maybe somebody over there just hates the whole franchise and is just trying to...
You make Tron build up, you put it in the corner next to freaking Star Wars at Disneyland, and you have Tron World and Star Wars World and freaking Avatar Land and then the rest of Disneyland. Then there's a reason to go to Disneyland again. Speaking of Star Wars, she was at a... her tattoo appointment. She's got a new tattoo in there. I don't know if you can see. It's Winnie the Pooh. She went to a tattoo appointment, and so I stayed home and caught up on Rebels last week. Tales of the Dark Saber with all the stuff with Sabine. Sabine is Rey's mom. That's what I'm going with. Okay. Or maybe at least her grandmother. I don't know. We're going there. Caught all the way up to the Saturday's episode. We just watched it with Mon Mothma and how she starts the rebellion. Just getting caught up on all that. Rebels is an amazing show. I know it's on Disney HD. Skip the commercials, watch it on DVR. Because the commercials are for like 12-year-olds and Rebels is for like adults. So, it's...
unless it's Christmas time, and then you can watch the commercials and find out what it is that you want for Christmas.
Wait a minute! It's the truth. But it's really, really awesome, and if you haven't watched it or caught up on it, there's just a bunch of stuff that happened since the mid-season stuff on. There has been really no filler episodes. Saw Gerrera. They actually had Forrest Whitaker play Saw Gerrera in the episodes. It was really, really well done. He is full crazy Saw Gerrera in those episodes. And Rebels is about, at this point in Rebels, it's about 2 years before Rogue One. So...
I just had a thought. The Collider thing that we were watching last night where they were talking... was it last night? Where they were talking about what's the standalone that they should announce at...
Celebration? Yeah.
Saw.
If they did a Saw... See, he's from Clone Wars. There's enough of the story... There's enough of the story where there's gaps there. That would make... Okay, I'll make that a Dark Horse pick. That would be really good. That would be good. I like that.
I like it better than Boba Fett.
It better be Obi-Wan or Ahsoka. Should be the new standalone movie that they announce it. Well, I'll do a whole preview episode of Celebration of stuff that I think is going to happen. And then we'll do a recap of Celebration when it happens.
And we can match them up and
see what happens. So I have all kinds of theories. I need to do a theory episode is what I need to do.
Oh, God.
Okay, we're moving on.
Sorry.
You see that? Fork in the Road is a big tangent. We're going to take this tree branch over here. So this weekend up in Seattle, in the rain, because it's Seattle, was the Emerald City Comic Con. I kept track of what was going on all weekend. I posted to the Facebook page. I was going to kind of keep showing stuff and highlights. There was a bunch of awesome cosplay. We were in and out a lot, so the hashtag hashtag ECCC 2017 on Twitter was keeping us track of everything. But there was a couple things that came out that I actually wanted to talk about because I have things. First off was the 6 foot tall 11 Funko Pop at the Funko booth with the Egos and the bloody nose. I want that in my house.
Where are you going to put it?
In the front yard. But there was other Funko stuff that came out. 11. Come on, you wouldn't think that.
How about the backyard so it won't get stolen?
I actually want the Hulkbuster, the 10-foot Hulkbuster that's in their office. That would just be amazing. The 11 and Barb and the Upside Down came out. The 2-pack. I guess you can get it at Hot Topic. Michigan the Frog. Hello, my baby. Hello, my darling. Hello, my... That came out, which... That's like my childhood, so I tough. And actually, he's got the tux and the tails and the top hat and the cane. Yeah.
Random.
Yeah, real random. I don't know. It was my childhood. I might have to get one. The World War II Captain America came out with the stagehand helmet and the goggles and the fake shield. Yeah. That one was really kind of cool. I watched a video of this thing that I didn't know I needed in my life called The Twisted Tunes, where it's a bunch of voice actors who get together and do scenes from movies as different characters. Fucking hilarious.
Yes.
We found their video from last year with Nolan North and Sean Astin showed up.
From
Phoenix Comic Con here. They did Ghostbusters. Oh my god, I got halfway through it and I fell asleep because I had watched like 3 hours of worth of stuff. So funny. I'm already on the they have to come to Phoenix Comic Con again. Yeah. The two things that really I kind of got that I for me kind of still getting into the whole con experience, and different cons have different things. Dragon Con's the very much about the cosplay, and San Diego's very much about the movie industry and the TV industry and all that stuff. So each con has a different, you know, feel and theme and kind of thing. Emerald City seems very much like a comic book con, and they had a full-on panel from Image Comics, and Image Comics is the one run by Todd McFarlane. Todd lives here in Phoenix, and he goes to Seattle to do a big freaking thing.
Not the Phoenix Comic Con. Not the
Phoenix one, because Phoenix one isn't kind of that way. I keep hoping, but I want him to do a comics panel and a toy panel. That's my thing. But he announced that the Spawn reboot is it's going forward, which could be really cool, because that kind of got away from him. But the really cool
as a movie or
as a movie,
okay,
as a movie. The right. The comic's still going, but as a,
they no, I just didn't know if they were doing like a series or like a Netflix thing would be kind of cool.
That would be kind of cool. Yeah, that would be awesome. But the cool thing that came out of that was Todd McFarlane actually moderated the Stan Lee panel, and Stan Lee's not going to a whole lot anymore. He's 965 years old.
He's like 95.
Okay, like I said, 905 years old. Stan Lee came bouncing out and was full of energy and high-fiving everybody and sat for his panel. And then I saw a bunch of the pictures and stuff like that. He took a bunch of pictures with people. Again, he sat because he's 95. But Todd McFarlane sat on the couch like this and had a conversation with Stan Lee for an hour and a half. And I'm like, do that shit here! Wouldn't it be cool?
It would. But Stan Lee's been here
within the last 3 years, 4 years,
two years, two or three years.
So
it'd be nice if he did one more.
It'd be nice. Yeah, he's on the kind of, they kind of been promoting, this is the last time at Salt Lake Comic Con, this is the last time at Emerald City, and last time at New York. So well, I'm hoping that was really cool to see that and have all that stuff come out of Emerald City. While we're talking about Comic-Cons, while we're talking about Phoenix Comic-Con, to be specific, Or Pacific Ocean.
Or Pacific.
A bunch of guest announcements have happened, and although I said we're not going to talk about stuff that happened in the last few weeks, so I'm going to bring up some of the names that have been named coming to Phoenix Comic Con. Min-Yang Nguyen, who plays Agent May in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is coming. John Cusack and
Joan.
Joan. Hey, I can read.
John would be her brother.
John would be in her. John would be fun too. Just do the whole Cusack panel, including the transsexual one. Joan Cusack and Kevin Conroy, who mostly now are voice actors, but they've been known for, you know, a bunch of different things, are coming. Anthony Michael Hall is coming, which could be a little interesting.
It's
what?
It's a weird. Anthony Michael Hall. Why?
I know.
I mean,
I know.
Weird.
Why was Ric Flair in Emerald City Comic Con? And Alice Cooper.
And Alice Cooper.
I understand. But the one I'm really excited for, it's on the cusp of maybe buying for photos, is Alan Tudyk. And so, really excited to kind of see, A, the panel, and B, kind of just all the shenanigans that are going on with that.
You have to, if you're going to do a photo with him, you have to do the, what is his line from Con Man?
I will see you in hell!
I will see you in hell!
I will see you in hell! I need a shirt. We need to get shirts made. It says, I will see you in hell. And there'll be like six people who get that joke, but that's okay. But Alan would be really cool. Jewel State was here a few years ago. Her panel was awesome. Adam Baldwin was here. I'm doing the whole Firefly thing. Was here a few years ago. Nathan Fillion was here a few years ago. There's a picture all over the internet of him doing a photo op with Bruce Campbell that was here. So Sean Mayer was here for
FanFest.
Summer Gall was here year before. So. And, you know, eventually maybe we can get them all in one spot and kind of corner them and then tell them that Fox wants to do a reboot.
you can't be released until you
agree.
Firefly.
Actually a bunch of the names have been kind of, for at least us, we're not into Once Upon a Time, and David Baker, Austin Green Phillips, whatever, the Green Power Ranger from the Power Ranger show was the big first one, and, you know, that's not our thing, so that's cool. But there's some names that are coming in here, and a bunch of more voice actors.
Yeah.
That seems to be the theme here, is a bunch of voice actors and the voice actor panels. I think we might have to go to some of those this year.
So then they should do the Twisted Tunes.
That was just a big ploy to get into a 2-hour panel with Twisted Tunes. That's all I want. So are you guys excited about Comic-Con? Did you guys see Logan? Who should be Cable in the new Cable movie? And can Disney die in a grease fire because they're fucking up Tron? So let us know. You can get a hold of us at Facebook at Pop Culture Cult. We're on Instagram at Pop Culture Cult 1. We're on the Twitters at Pop_Cult1. You can also here on YouTube. Please like this video, comment on it, share it with your friends. We're trying to get to 100 subscribers by Memorial Day weekend, which happens to coincide with a Comic-Con here in the Valley. No show for us next week because we need a vacation from our vacation, and we will be in Las Vegas, probably touring the Marvel Station exhibit.
Oh, we'll do a... We could do a review.
We could totally do a review.
When we get back.
We might do a live stream while we're there. I wonder if we can get away with that. I don't know. But anyways.
We'll see.
Please let us know what you guys are thinking. Please share it with your friends. And until next time. Where's the button? Good night now.
If you have any poo, fling it.